It's time for our stock of the hour. Now, shares of American Express rising to an intraday high this after the Supreme Court threw out a government lawsuit accusing Amex of thwarting competition. Joining us with more now is Taylor Riggs. It had to do with merchants, Taylor.
Right, exactly. So it's really interesting. The U.S. government had claimed that Amex had sort of thwarted off competition by prohibiting merchants from sort of steering customers away from using their cards, perhaps using credit cards with lower fees. So they ruled in a 5-4 case here that the government and 11 states had failed to prove that Amex not only had harmed cardholders, but that they hadn't harmed merchants as well. So I wanted to take a look at the merchant discount rate, because as we know, this comes down to fees, and Amex typically has higher fees than some of its competitors. So if you come into my terminal here, I have a BI chart showing just the average discount rate. Now, that is the measure of fees that Amex charges its merchants. It has been falling now about 2.37% of total sales, but they're looking to increase the merchant acceptance rate. That, of course, will be key. They're in about 8.5 million active U.S. merchants. Visa and MasterCard are in about 10.1 million. So sort of this push-pull dynamic between the fees and then, of course, the merchant acceptance rate.
Yeah, and what does it mean for the merchants going forward? And also the defeat for Discover card services. That's something that seems to have got a bit of a blow as the rules undercut, therefore, the ability to compete.
Yeah, really worried about their ability to compete as well. You can see shares of Visa and MasterCard are falling today as well in reaction to that announcement. And, you know, what is interesting is that, you know, it might be near-term negative for them. Like we said, the dichotomy and the push-pull between getting in to merchants and that merchant acceptance rate versus having those lower discount rates that maybe doesn't pull in as much revenue.